Designed for the US Armed Forces, it is one of the most advanced anti-tank missiles in the world. Equipped with infrared guidance system, heat warhead, and two-stage solid-fuel rocket motor, this armor-piercing high-precision weapon can destroy or neutralize any modern military tank. Today, we'll look at the design, development, and working of the FGM-148 Javelin anti-tank guided missile in detail. You're watching SYG Documentary. On March 3, 1996, the American Aerospace and Defense Company Raytheon designed the FGM-77 anti-tank missile system. It was manufactured by Raytheon and McDonnell Douglas. Also known as the M-47 Dragon, it was a man-portable shoulder-launched missile system. It was mainly designed to defeat the Soviet Union's T-55, T-62, and T-72 tanks. The FGM-77 was used in the Lebanon War, Iran-Iraq War, Western Sahara War, the Persian Gulf War, and the Yemen Civil War. Even after proving its capabilities in real combat situations, the US Army wasn't really happy with the missile system. The major disadvantage of the FGM-77 was that it was not a fire-and-forget missile, meaning the missile had to be guided towards the target until the final impact, and to do that, a long wire had to be attached to the missile. If the target was at a distance of 1 kilometer, they had to attach a kilometer-long wire to the missile. This would limit its range. The missile also had a huge backblast. It made a lot of noise which would alert the enemies, and the smoke produced by it would give away the location of the operator and very less time to relocate. At the same time, military tanks around the world were getting more advanced with more powerful protective armor called the explosive reactive armor. These types of armors were first installed on Israeli tanks during the 1982 Lebanon War, and they were very effective against anti-tank weapons. The US Army understood that they needed a new and more advanced technology to counter these developments. Hence, they proposed a requirement for a new anti-tank missile system. In June 1989, the full-scale development contract for the new advanced anti-tank weapon system was awarded to the joint venture of Texas Instruments and Martin Marietta, now known as Lockheed Martin. The newly designed system was the FGM-148 Javelin armor-piercing anti-tank guided missile system. This system was and still is one of the most advanced missile systems in the world. With the help of animation, we'll look at it in detail. This is the FGM-148 Javelin missile. Weighs about 22.3 kilograms in ready-to-fire condition. The length of the missile is 1.1 meters, and the length of the launch tube is 1.2 meters. The missile diameter is 127 millimeters, and the launch tube diameter is 142 millimeters. It has a range of 2.5 to 4.75 kilometers. Flying faster than the speed of sound, it can reach supersonic speeds up to Mach 1.7 and can reach maximum altitude of 150 meters. It is equipped with high explosive anti-tank warhead or heat warhead, also known as shaped charge or tandem charged warhead, and it weighs 8.4 kilograms. It has two-staged solid fuel rocket motor and uses infrared homing guidance system. It has two modes of attack, direct attack and top attack. And it's a fire and forget missile, meaning once the missile is fired, the operator doesn't have to guide it towards the target. Now let's see how it works. The Javelin missile system consists of three main parts: the launch tube, the command launch unit or the CLU, and the Javelin missile itself. Let's focus on the missile first. It has four main parts: the guidance section, warhead section, mid-body section, and the propulsion section. The front part, or the nose of the missile, has an infrared seeker. It looks something like this. Infrared cameras cannot see pictures like the normal cameras. Instead, they only see the thermal signatures or the heat signatures. This helps the missile to lock onto the target and follow the target easily. Next is the warhead section. Javelin uses high explosive anti-tank warhead or HEAT warhead. They are also called shape-charged or tandem-charged warhead. These types of warheads are capable of penetrating thick protective armors used on modern military tanks. It consists of an explosive charge, and in front of it will be a cone-shaped metal, usually made of copper. When the explosive is set off, the metal cone melts immediately, gets squeezed, and comes out in the form of a jet. This jet can travel up to 10 km per second, which is enough to destroy or neutralize a military tank. The next section is the mid-body section. In Javelin missile, the mid-body section holds 8 deployable wings. These wings are deployed when the missile comes out of the launch tube. It helps in stabilizing the missile when it is moving towards the target. The last part is the propulsion section. The Javelin missile has 2-staged solid rocket motor. Whenever a missile is launched, it creates a lot of noise and smoke. This is called backblast. To reduce backblast, the Javelin missile uses 2-staged solid rocket motor. When the operator presses the fire trigger, the missile is gently pushed out of the launch tube. This is called soft launch, and it is done to reduce backblast. The first stage motor is used for soft launch. The second stage motor starts once the missile is out of the launch tube. It keeps the missile in flight until it hits the target. The missile also has 4 movable tail fins to control or change the direction during flight. Now, let's look at the launch tube assembly. This is the Javelin missile launch tube with command launch unit attached to it. Together, they are called the launch tube assembly. This is the launch tube with front cap, end cap, and shoulder pad. The caps will protect the launch tube from moisture, dust, and damages during transportation. The shoulder pad is used to provide balance and support to the operator when it's placed on the shoulder. This is the command launch unit, or the CLU. It carries all the necessary electronics to operate the system. It consists of day sight lens, night vision sight lens, which can be used during both day and night operation. It has battery compartment and absorber, which protects the CLU from damages during transportation, and also it protects the operator's face from the missile's exhaust flame when it leaves the launch tube. It also has DVOR cooling system, which keeps the CLU from overheating. It also has 2 hand grips, and both of them have controls to operate the CLU. The left-hand grip controls are only used to detect and lock on to the target. It has a seeker trigger, which is used to narrow down and lock on to the target. It comes with trigger guard to prevent accidental selection. Behind that, you will find the eyepiece through which the operator looks at the target, and other controls like STT selection, focus, and filter. On the right-hand grip controls, you'll find buttons to change the contrast and brightness. and you'll get an attack selection switch to switch between direct attack and top attack. In front of the handle, there is a fire trigger. Pressing this trigger will fire the missile. Now let's see how the missile is launched. It takes two people to use this missile system. One person will place the missile in the launch tube, and the other person will operate the CLU and fires the missile. The operator can launch the missile in four different positions. Sitting position, kneeling position, standing supported position, and the prone supported position. Like I have already said, the Javelin missile has two modes of attack, direct attack and top attack. Let's look at the direct attack mode. First, the missile is placed in the launch tube. But before that, take a look at the wings and fins. They are in retracted position until the missile is fired. The missile is placed in the launch tube. This is called feeding. Now we need a target to destroy. Next, the operator looks through the eyepiece and locates the target. With the help of left-hand grip controls, he will then select the target and locks onto it. Depending on the visibility, he can switch between infrared view and daylight view. Once the target is locked, the operator will then select the direct attack mode on the right-hand grip controls and then presses the fire trigger. Once the fire trigger is pressed, the first stage solid rocket motor will soft launch the missile out of the launch tube. Once the missile is out of the launch tube, the wings are deployed. Now, the second stage solid rocket motor starts and the missile moves towards the target and hits it head-on with extreme precision. This is called direct attack. Direct attack is used only when the target is clearly visible. Most anti-tank missiles in the world has only one mode of attack, and that is direct attack. Let's look at the second attack mode that makes Javelin one of the deadliest anti-tank missiles in the world, the top attack. Just like the direct attack mode, the missile is first soft launched out of the launch tube, and then the second stage rocket motor ignites. This is when the Javelin shows its real skill. The missile moves forward a bit and then immediately gains altitude by going up at a very steep angle. Locates the target from above. Comes down nearly at a vertical angle of attack and strikes the target. This is called top attack. Top attack is used on targets that are either partially or completely hidden. Also, military tanks have less protection on the top. They have heavy armor around them, but the armor on top is usually thin. This is done to reduce the weight of the tank, which will increase its fuel efficiency. The thin armor makes them vulnerable to being attacked from top. Even though modern tanks are equipped with advanced active protection system, it is still difficult to counter a fast-moving missile attacking from the top. The FGM-148 Javelin missile system has already been used in the Afghanistan War, Iraq War, Syrian Civil War, and Libyan Civil War. In all these wars, it has proven its combat capabilities. But it also has some drawbacks. The main drawback is that the entire system weighs 22.3 kilograms. This is heavy for a shoulder-launched missile system. Another major drawback is that each missile costs around $175,000. And if you include the cost of the command launch unit, the price will go well above $200,000. This is because Javelin uses off-the-shelf parts which are used only in this missile system and are manufactured using cutting-edge technologies. The Javelin missile system entered service with the US Army units in 1996. In 2001, the FGM-77 or the M-47 Dragon missile system was retired from the US military service and was replaced by the Javelin. Today, the Javelin is being used in Australia, Czech Republic, France, Indonesia, Ireland, Libya, New Zealand, Saudi Arabia, United Arab Emirates, USA, and 11 other countries. Germany and India also participated in the bid to purchase this system, but the bidding failed. India wanted to manufacture the system locally, and hence they asked the US to share the technology through TOT, or Transfer of Technology, but the US government refused the proposal. In 2013, the US offered co-development of a newer version of Javelin missile system, but this time the Indian government refused the deal. In 2014, every plan to purchase Javelin missile system was suspended by India. In the end, India bought Spike missile system from Israel. As of September 2021, more than 5,000 Javelin missiles have been fired in combat, guaranteeing a hit almost every time and piercing through the thick armor of enemy tanks. The FGM-148 Javelin missile system still remains one of the most feared anti-tank missile systems in the world. Keep watching SYG Documentary. I am Suyog, and that's it for today's video. Thank you.